Welcome back, everybody, and it's time for Thursday's NATO Plays, and today NATO is playing LA Noire Part 2, and what we're going to do, we just got promoted up to traffic, and we're going to go ahead and do the first case of traffic. Now, each one of these episodes for LA Noire is going to be each case, so some videos may be shorter than others. Just keep in mind that this is not one of those games where you rush into things. You have to pay attention. I'll keep you updated as we go through, but show NATO some love. I'm Angel. This is Gaming with Angels. Let's get started with LA Noire.
We attracted to each other like the opposite poles, pulling towards each other. We can't say no, and won't say no. So hot in here, I wish I had a window. Electric, magnetic, energetic, and there's nothing else like it. The way hot body feels, don't wanna ever feel another feeling. Got me exploding like I overloaded, baby. Let's go.
Here's your new desk, kid. You're on traffic. The hot sheet is posted here, next to the map.
What's his problem?
That's Biggs. He's an institution.
So this is what all the fuss is about. Why couldn't they build a freeway that goes past my place?
They haven't even approved the money yet, kid. The bond issue won't be till December. It'll be years before any of this will happen. Here's your new partner, Stefan Berkowski.
I've heard all about you, Phelps. You go easy on me and let me earn the odd citation, and maybe we'll get along fine. I'm here to learn, Detective.
He's an intense one, isn't he, Mel?
Who's intense?
The newly minted detective here, Cole Phelps.
Hi, Phelps. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I could spend a little time basking in reflected glory. Make a change from busting hookers and dope fiends.
Who was that, Commander?
Roy Earle, chief detective and Ed Vice.
Do they all dress like movie stars?
Roy is a movie star. And the whole of the seedy side of L.A. is his audience.
What is that supposed to mean?
Stick with me, kid. You'll find out.
Now some housekeeping. Warm Central Division welcome for Detective Cole Phelps. Some of you guys may know Phelps. He's the cop who broke the jewelry store murder. Stand up and take a bow, Phelps.
If it's all right with you,
sir. That's an order, Phelps.
Ooh.
Shh, quiet, everybody.
Phelps is one of only two serving LAPD officers who received the Silver Star during the war. Really gave it those lousy Japanese, eh, Phelps?
I did my best, Captain.
Why are you war heroes always so modest? I partnered Phelps with everybody's favorite Pole, Stefan Bukowski.
Hope you like work, kid. Bukowski sure as hell doesn't.
Well, that's why we have partners, right?
Okay, can it, guys. Stick with Bukowski. He's a good cop. He knows traffic inside and out. I'm gonna start you out with one case. You do okay, I'll give you a couple more. You screw up, you'll be rousing vagrants and running license plates. Now get down to the P.E. Freight Depot, 6th and Alameda. A patrolman called in a suspicious vehicle. Signs of foul play. See what you can find out.
Come on, Phelps.
Okay.
Do you think this lipstick's too light for my complexion?
They really pushed you through quick, didn't they? 6 years on patrol before I got this desk. You were here in 5 minutes.
What do you want me to say? I didn't ask for any favors.
They do a lot of side chatter in this game, so it's hard for me to comment.
You know this place?
Of these things.
Sure. Near the old gas works and signal depot in the warehouse district. I'll direct.
So, but one of the things, and hopefully it happens during this particular drive around, is the music. They do use a lot of 1940s music. You will notice the date. It is January of 1947, which means that it is literally 4 months after the official end of World War II. World War II ended in September of 1946 or 1945. So, 1946. So we do have some time frames there that we're looking at. It's really close to when the war actually fully ended. So
So,
tell me a little about yourself, Phelps. Are we friends now, Bukowski?
We have to work together, don't be so touchy.
I grew up in San Francisco. My father was in shipping. Went to college at Stanford. Did 2 years ROTC before Marine OCS at Camp Elliott. Shipped out in early 45 as a first lieutenant. Fought in the Okinawa campaign. I was wounded. Shipped back home. A year on the beat. Now I'm here.
So you won the Silver Star.
I don't want to talk about it.
Now let me get this straight. You single-handedly killed 40 Japs on this hill in Okinawa.
No. You were up there all night, draped in the flag, knife between your teeth, gun at the ready. Finished?
The Emperor Hirohito himself leading the charge against you.
I did my part, Bukowski. What did you do?
I kept the streets of L.A. safe for the people.
Yeah. Now I get it. Unfit for service.
Now fuck you, Phelps. I earned a bravery citation during the Zooter riots.
Sounds like you had it rough. I did my job. No one is saying you didn't.
I did 6 years as a patrolman.
That's the third time you've told me.
1 year and 4 months since the end of the war. That is my bad. We got eggs to lay. We got ground to dig and worms to scratch. It takes a lot of setting, getting chicks to hatch. Oh, there ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So quiet yourself and stop whining fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. Kindly point that gun the other way and hobble, hobble, hobble off and hit the hay. This car is trying to park and also not sure if it's turning or moving or what.
It's a busy day, we got things to do, we got eggs to lay, we got ground to dig and worms to scratch. It takes a lot of setting, getting chicks to hatch. There ain't nobody here but us chickens. There ain't nobody here at all. So quiet yourself and stop that fuss. There ain't nobody here but us. And kindly point that gun the other way and hobble, hobble, hobble off and hit the hay. Hey, hey, boss man, what do you say? It's easy pickings. There ain't nobody here but us chickens.
KTI reminds you a great job awaits you in the United States Army. Enlist now at your nearest U.S. Army recruiting station. Starting salaries at $75 per month.
That's a lot of money for back in 1947.
To an interesting situation. You wake up in the morning feeling weak. It could be a deficiency of iron. Iron you need for healthy blood and bones. That's why it's time to rise and shine. Yes, Rise and Shine Yeast keeps your body physically fit. Your body requires iron daily. And what better way to give you the iron you need than Rise and Shine Yeast in your breads and cakes? Rise and Shine Yeast is a natural source of vitamins. Physician studies show 3 out of 4 women lack sufficient iron. If you are losing weight, feeling run down, weak, or easily upset, get the vigor and pep you need by using Rise and Shine Yeast and by taking Rise and Shine Yeast tablet supplements. It helps regain strength and needed pounds to feel and do your best. Go to your grocer or druggist and say,
Rise and Shine, please.
We now return you to regular programming.
That's great. Yeast tablets. Yeast tablets for iron deficiency, which isn't that far from the truth.
Who knows how much I love you? You do.
My head's in front of the map. I mean, I can, like, you know, way over the sea. We still got a minute to get there.
Who makes life necessary?
That you, Bukowski? Go on through. Parking lot straight ahead.
Uh, I need to get back to work, officer.
The detectives are here now. You repeat to them what you told me.
I did the right thing by calling this in. I'm just a working stiff.
Just give them your story and you'll be all right.
This is your first case, Phelps. It's okay to admit it if you're stumped. If you don't know what to do next, just come talk to me and we'll see what we can figure out.
Thanks, Stefan. You're okay.
I'm Officer Hart.
Phelps, traffic. What have you got?
Abandoned car, probably stolen. The solid citizen is Nate Wilkie. He called it in.
What gives with the coroner?
There's blood all over the interior. Someone's copped a full Broderick, but no stiff as yet.
We have an owner for the car?
The car is registered to an Adrian Black, just north of Bunker Hill.
All right, we'll take a look around.
I'll keep Mr. Wilkie talking, but don't make him wait too long. He's the restless type.
Okay, so one of the things that this game does is...
How long are you gonna keep me here, sir?
Gives you tones, but it's not necessarily a clue that you're looking at.
Doc?
Detective
Phelps, what have we got?
A lot of blood for a blunt force injury. The victim must be in a very bad way.
Any sign of the guy?
Not unless he's in the trunk of the car.
Victim looks to have lost a lot of blood.
Seems irrelevant.
Mr. F. Morgan picked up a live pig yesterday? Brand name might give us something to go on. Married, 32 years old, married. Sounds like an average guy. What was he doing out here?
I also like that the license expires after 1 year, not 8 or 20 or whatever.
Happier times, I guess.
So he's married to the Joker. Long face. She just looks evil.
Stenzel glasses. Home repaired by the look of it.
Get all tape around the center.
Sir, I'm Detective Phelps.
Name's Nate Wilkie.
You found the vehicle?
Sure. Saw it just sitting there. Strange place to be parking your car. Figured I'd better take a look. And then I saw all the blood. So I called the police.
Okay.
Mind if I ask what you were doing out here?
Well, I work for the railway. I was on my way out to the switch and reckon I'd take a shortcut.
So I like how the game kind of does this, like, half glitch when it changes their face to see if you're going to be the good cop, the bad cop, or accuse them.
Did you see anybody else in the yard? Maybe somebody hanging around the car?
Nope. I hadn't seen a soul all day till you boys turned up.
Do you know Adrian Black, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. That ain't a name I'm familiar with.
You ever seen the car before?
Funny enough, I did. A couple of nights ago, it was over there in the parking lot. I know most of the cars that park here regularly, so it kind of stood out.
We found a steel pipe with blood on it near the car. Do you know anything about it, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. I went straight for the law when I saw the car was full of blood.
When you saw the blood, was it wet, bright red, or darker like it is now?
Darker, I'd say. Looked dry already.
All right.
The wallet by the car. Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
Do you want the patrolman to hold you down while we turn out your pockets, Mr. Wilkie?
Maybe I checked inside that wallet. Not that I was gonna steal anything. Maybe I took a look. But there weren't no money in there. Not even change.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Wilkie. We'll contact your employer if we need anything more from you.
If you have to, I guess. I can't really spend no more time over this.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps. If you're done here, we'll head over there now.
Yeah, so when they're being honest, there's a small glitch right in the middle, right just above the eyes and in the forehead where it just kind of smooths out. But when they're doing this whole, what are you trying to accuse me of? And that's when the facial animations kick in and you see them looking all over the place and stuff like that, so. All right. If I am not mistaken, we've got to drive right back across town to get to the house of Mr. and Mrs. Adrian Black. Yep. Way the hell up there.
Bunker Hill Avenue. You know where that is?
Behind Bunker Hill. A couple blocks north of Central Station.
So, what do we tell the wife?
Play it by the book. No stiff yet, so let's see how it plays out. Could be a car theft gone wrong. Make Black drive somewhere lonely, then give him a tap.
But why leave the car?
Well, obviously someone got a little heavy-handed.
it's the wrong way around.
Well, how so, genius?
Where is Adrian? If you've gone to all the trouble to steal the car and it goes wrong, you leave the body behind, not the car.
You got something there, Phelps. It doesn't add up.
All units of 459 just occurred at 6th and Ceres. Any unit to handle, code 2 identified.
You read about the guy in the crossing yesterday?
Oh, what happened?
Over on Lincoln Avenue. This guy's driving along and his oil light comes on. He stops the car and gets out. He pops the hood and...
he's on a rail crosser.
Oh, you got it. He's got his head under there checking the oil, and the Southern Pacific freight slams into his car doing 90 miles an hour. The car came to a rest more than a mile down the track.
Yikes.
What a pointless waste of life.
You'll get plenty of blood and guts and mindless stupidity working traffic, Phelps.
Oh, yeah.
And who needs a Second Amendment when we'll give a goddamn fool the license to get behind the wheel of an automobile?
It's the same reason why you're not allowed to take the Try Me stickers off
the toys. If it's a kidnapping, why leave the victim's ID? If it's a murder, why leave the car? The evidence doesn't add up.
Free lesson, Phelps. Evidence will only get you so far. You ask me, the whole thing feels hinky as hell.
What I wouldn't give to have your powers of intuition, Bukowski.
Don't worry, kid. Keep watching the master and you'll get there one day.
Watching the stoplight. Now, at the end of every case, it does tell you how much property damage you caused, any type of civilian injuries, things like that. That will be relevant later in a different video. That light just didn't change, so there is that. I like looking around too, like over here we've got the we've got the bargain store over here on this side, and then up to my north side of me is the church. There's the auto park and the gas station on the other side, and then the hot dog vendors. This is really cool. I love the detail, you know. It's like right here, stow it, don't throw it. Look at right there.
Thank you.
this is definitely a lot different than driving in something like GTA or in the Mako on Mass Effect. Shit, anything. Drive a tank around in Call of Duty or whatever, it's still, there's a big difference between these cars and... Oh, a little blue mailbox, cool. What I haven't seen yet is a payphone. Then there's a police phone up here on the left, a little blue box. The police call box, that's what those are.
Let's go introduce ourselves. You talk to her, Phelps. I'm no good at this shoulder to cry on stuff.
Just a minute.
LAPD, Mrs. Black. May we come in? We have some bad news and we'd rather discuss this in private.
I'm Margaret Black. We can discuss this in the living room. Please come in.
Your husband drives a blue Lincoln, Mrs. Black?
That's correct.
The car has been found abandoned, and I'm afraid there are signs of foul play.
I knew something was wrong when he didn't come home.
We believe your husband may be injured. We found a pipe on the scene with blood on it.
Oh, no! My poor Adrian!
Does the name Instaheat mean anything to you, ma'am?
Yes, it does. We've just had a new water heater installed.
Whereabouts, Mrs. Black?
Just outside the kitchen window, at the side of the house.
I'd like you to try and stay calm and remember everything that you can about last night. My partner and I are going to take a look around. When you're ready, we're going to have some more questions for you. Is that okay?
Of course, officer. Anything to help secure my husband's safety.
Anything to secure
Let's
my
check
husband's
the place out.
Safety.
Come on.
This is another prime example of where it'll give you a tone like that, and you can look at stuff, but it may not necessarily be a clue.
Have a good look around. There's got to be something in here to go on.
Can't rush it.
A used ticket to Seattle and a suitcase gone missing. Someone couldn't wait to get out of this house.
42.65 to get to Seattle from Los Angeles.
This must be Adrian's. Stencil. So the glasses are a match. separate bedrooms, separate pictures. What gives here? To my Adrian.
Ooh.
This thing gets more and more interesting.
My goodness. Adrian's been naughty.
Kavanaugh's. So who brought this home?
Well, they're in his bedroom.
Maybe Adrian was a patron. And I should have an address.
InstaHeat, the new automatic glass-lined gas water heater. 20 gallons. That's it. $82 for installation and complete. And I tell you what, they don't make things like they used to. Popping or flashbacks. They cannot rust or corrode. They're guaranteed for 10 years. Yeah. Well, we know it today as on-demand hot water. So $82.50 cash, $8.50 down. Easy terms. Still get credit on $82. So, I mean, equivalently today, that's about right. Shipping weight, 185 pounds.
This was only recently installed, not 2 days ago.
Installation, $12.
Maybe it's time we took a look around outside.
Pipe work and plumbing, $11. Delivery, his thumb's over it, so I can't see. But yeah, I mean, easy. Installation, $12. $12 to get a fast food meal anymore. And you didn't supersize it. That is a nice vacuum cleaner, though. Look at the washing machine! Which reminds me, I did not look in the kitchen to see if she actually had a push-button dishwasher, which those were available. Doesn't look like it, but a lot of them were inside cabinet doors. So, it is possible that there's one in there somewhere. But, dishwashers were actually available in the 1930s. A lot of people don't realize that, and they weren't very popular, but they were available. And what we know today is, or what was known then as push button magic, was really, really popular beginning in the late 1940s and early 1950s. So,
no use leaving the thing half finished.
Right, yeah.
So the pipe missing from Mr. Black's heater is the same one that killed him. Huh. Seems like the assailant is a little closer to home.
Okay, we do need to find the phone so that we can call for the address of Kavanaugh's bar. She does have an electric range, though. That makes me happy. Ooh, newspaper.
Lie down. Make yourself comfortable. So, you're a friend of Courtney's?
Yes, Doctor.
He seems very concerned about you.
I have these visions. These blinding visions. I can't get them out of my head. My skull, it feels like it's in a vise.
I want to give you something to calm your nerves. I want to take you on a journey. A journey back. I want you to remember the good things about your past. Occasions that made you laugh. Times that made you smile.
Oh, telephone. Yay. Oh, she left her shoes out. Shame on her. Bad 40s wife.
Operator, give me dispatch.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address on a Kavanaugh's bar.
Certainly, Detective. One moment. Kavanaugh's bar. Corner of Aliso and Hewitt, south side of Union Station.
Thanks, ma'am.
I'm all right now, detectives.
All right, let's talk about it.
We found a receipt in the trunk of your husband's car for a live pig. This receipt was made out to an F. Morgan.
A pig? Adrian runs a tool business. That would be Frank Morgan. God knows what he's up to.
What makes you say that about Morgan, ma'am?
He's the foreman at my husband's plant. A very shady character. I told Adrian he needs to keep his distance from the staff. They're always out drinking together.
Was your husband wearing his glasses when he left here yesterday?
Yes, he just bought a new pair.
Okay.
Go on.
I kept telling him to throw those old ones away. He tried to repair them with tape. They looked terrible.
Did your husband tell you where he was going last night?
All he said was he was gonna meet Frank for a drink.
So nothing out of the usual then?
Well, he came home early from work. He never comes home early. And he went out early, too. He normally never leaves for the bar till about 7.
Tell us about the photo of Adrian in the bedroom.
What is there to tell? It's from his most recent business trip to Seattle.
There's plenty to tell. You just won't tell it. You're lying about the photograph, Mrs. Black.
You're incredibly rude and insensitive. But I guess you know that. I've told you what I know about the picture.
Evidence.
What about Nicole, Mrs. Black? Was your husband going to leave you for her?
I've seen the photo frame. He thinks I'm stupid. But women sense these things. I don't know if he intended to leave me or if it was just a fling. God only knows. I only want to know that he's safe.
Your husband frequents Kavanaugh's bar?
How did you know that? Adrian,
kind of hard to miss
there after work.
So Adrian spends a lot of time there.
Up until recently, he's been away in Seattle a lot on business.
I think you should come clean with us, Mrs. Black. Your husband is missing, and after our search, I'm willing to call the circumstances suspicious. Can you account for your movements last night?
You're not accusing me, are you? Oh, what an awful thing to say. I was here all night, of course, waiting for Adrian to come home.
Is there anyone who can vouch for that?
Well, no. I was here alone. I cooked Adrian's dinner and waited, but he never came home.
We'll keep you informed, Mrs. Black.
Please do, Detective.
All right, so we're gonna go to Kavanaugh's bar next. Which I believe is back down by the railway station area.
Jesus, I'm glad to be out of there.
Mr. and Mrs. Black don't seem to have the happiest home life.
He's too scared to divorce her, and she's too much of a shrinking violet to throw him out. If this hadn't happened, they could have stayed miserable together forever.
You think she could have killed him?
She sure as hell doesn't seem the type. Stranger things have happened.
Help those who need it the most. Donate today, won't you? And be sure to buy your victory bonds, available at your favorite movie theater.
Any unit to handle, code 2, identify.
Honestly, I don't think we've ever done any of the side arrests or the side dispatches. I don't think we've ever done any of them. But stage screen and radio. Okay, so I've seen a bakery, a butcher shop, a liquor store, a couple of dress stores, and tailor shops. There's a gentleman's store over there on the left. Yes, and you throw the cookbook away. Bobby Sock, baby. You've got a head full of nothing but stage, screen, and radio. We got Trade World. Now you treat me like a stranger. Tobacconist. You don't have a word to say. I ask you if you love me. Another bakery. What will Frankie say? Yes, Bobby's son, baby. I've got to let you go.
Any unit in the vicinity, see the man at 211 just occurred. 3rd and Hill Street. Stand by for further unit to handle code 3.
Here we have ourselves a drugstore. Furniture store.
Another musical favorite brought to you by Bullseye Brand Cigarettes. Tykes Williams.
Now, I'm a feller with a heart of gold, with the ways of a gentleman, I've been told. The kind of a feller that wouldn't even harm a plea. But if me and a certain character met, the guy that invented the cigarette, I'd murder that son of a gun in the first degree. It ain't cause that I don't smoke myself. I don't reckon they hinder your health. I've smoked them all my life. And
smoke yourself to death. Tell St. Peter at the Golden Gate that you hate to make him wait, but you just gotta have another cigarette. The other night, old Dame Fortune was doing me right. The kings and the queens, they just kept on coming round. Then I got a full and I bet a tie, but my bluff didn't work on a certain guy. He just kept on a-raising and a-laying the money down. Now he'd raise me and I'd raise him. I sweated blood, I got a sink or swim. He finally called and then didn't raise the bet. I said, ace is full, pal, how about you? And he said, well, I'll tell you in just a minute or two, but right now I just gotta have a cigarette.
Smoke, smoke, smoke that cigarette. Puff, 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 and if you smoke yourself to death.
Tell St. Peter at the Golden Gate that you hate to make him wait, but you just gotta have another cigarette.
Songs that would be totally banned in today's day and age. Stores,
the other night, I had a date with the cutest little girl in the 48 states, a hybrid uptown fancy little dame. Now, she said she loved me, and it seemed to me that things were just about like they ought to be, so hand in hand, we strolled down Lover's Lane. She was oh so far from a chunk of ice, and our smooching party was going real nice, so help me, Hannah, I think I'd have been there yet. I give her a kiss and a little squeeze, and she said, Tex, excuse me, please, but I just gotta have another cigarette.
Smoke, smoke, smoke that cigarette. Puff, 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 and if you smoke yourself to death.
Tell St. Peter at the Golden Gate that you hate to make him wait, but you just gotta...
There we go. The music makes me happy. It's such a fun tune. I know it's a bad tune.
I know you.
No, you don't.
You know you. No, you don't.
Looking for someone?
God, I say that all the time.
Sam's taking me out of Palm Springs.
You know Frank Morgan?
Sure. Frank's your regular. He's a loner in the back.
Tell the cook these were some good grits.
Boy, that steak has seen better
Frank
days.
Morgan?
Who's asking?
Cole Phelps, LAPD. I understand you're a friend of Adrian Black.
Yeah, I know him.
Are you aware that he's missing?
No, I hadn't heard that. Tough break.
Yeah.
We found Black's car abandoned in a freight depot, covered in blood. You know anything about that, Morgan?
Hell no. I'm sorry to hear that. I like Adrian. He's a good boss.
Please, don't tell me you actually believe this jerk-off, Phelps.
You're lying, Morgan. You were there.
And you're talking out your ass, detective. How about you prove I was out at that rail yard?
Oh, my God. If you watch Gamer Poop, that's where that came from. Oh.
You were there, Morgan. We found a receipt in the trunk of the car. It has your name on it. We can call the slaughter yard and nail you on it.
All right, already. That fool Adrian's fallen for some dame in Seattle. He wanted me to make it look like he'd been attacked.
All right, where is he? Let's find out.
Where exactly is Black holed up?
No idea. I think he took off for Seattle.
Back up.
I'm tired of your shtick, Morgan. Spill it, or we take you out in the alley and we knock it out of you.
He's holed up at my place. He's waiting for some money to come through before he blows town.
An address?
It's an apartment house at the corner of Temple and Figueroa. Apartment number 2.
I think that's all. Thanks for your help, Morgan. We appreciate it.
Hey, I'm just glad I could help. I love cops.
Cuff him, let him go. It's up to you, Phelps. There's no way I'm writing this idiot up. You got Morgan's address? Let's get over to his apartment.
All right, where the hell we gotta go now? Oh my God, way back up there in the top. See, we're facing south? I don't know. I know we played this one time and we made the partner drive. Every single trip.
I've met some pretty good liars in my time. People who sound convincing because they actually believe their own bullshit. That type is clever, hard to catch out.
Frank Morgan is not one of those people.
No, he is not.
KGPL calling car 11K. 11K, come in.
11K, go ahead.
Message from Technical Services. Bug found in the abandoned Lincoln at the DE 3. Swine is the most likely match.
Roger, KGPL. Kind of reel this guy in, Phelps.
Did you? Holy shit! Did you just see? Oh my God! There's a trash can in the middle. This is what happened to LA. I swear by it. Gonna keep right on cruising. He didn't even stop. He rolled it.
Oh my God. He like took out a light post and a bench and a trash bin and... Yeah, I don't blame him.
Any in the vicinity, see the man at 211 just occurred. Burton Hill Street. Stand by for further unit to handle code 3 identified.
Still getting over the fact that we just watched a truck take out all of that, like right on a corner. Dentist? Okay, yeah. A dentist. That checks. It's like a travel agency up there.
Check the place out. Come on.
Apartment 2.
Help you, gentlemen? LAPD detectives, Mr. Black. You're under arrest. Look, I'm really sorry about this. I never tried to hurt anyone. I just needed to get away from L.A. I won't put up a struggle. Just let me get my things.
I knew it! Phelps, go after him. I'll try and hit him off in the car. Remember, the gun is the last resort.
There's no point running, Adrian. Mr. Black, get back here right now. It's over, Adrian.
Why not just come clean with her, Black? Why the melodrama?
I thought it would be easier.
No, it just got a whole lot harder. Adrian Black, you're under arrest for conspiracy and fraud. We'll see what the DA has to say about wasting police resources on a wild goose chase like this.
You're gonna lose your wife, lose your job, and probably end up in the big house. I hope she was worth it, Adrian.
That's fair.
That turned out to be quite some case, huh? Adrian, what an idiot. You got an arrest and a clearance in your first case, and in fine style, too. Well done, detective. Efficient investigation technique, good public presence. You keep that up and you learn from Bukowski here, you could go a long way in this department.
Okay, that's where I was going to say it's important, public presence. Not running over a lamppost and a bench with the cops sitting right next to you. So see right here, up here on the screen, it does say your conduct, vehicle damage, injuries, and city damage that you could have caused. It is very important to try to keep those numbers as low as possible. This is not GTA. All right, folks, so thank you so much for watching. Give NATO some love down at the bottom. Remember, it's today his day. Thursday is NATO Plays, and I'll see everybody next week right here on Gaming with Angels. You can save yourself.